Here, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of World of Final Fantasy. World of Final Fantasy.
The World of Final Fantasy.
The World of Final Fantasy. Here on PasticheofSkin, we are just finished off Chapter 8 of the game. Obviously, you've probably found this. If you've caught us in media ray, you can, of course, go back and catch the previous episodes in the playlist. Remember to always check out youtube.com/PasticheofSkin for the newest episodes. And let's just get ourselves riding right along. So, essentially, in the last episode, what we were doing was just trying to find ourselves a boat to get ourselves to the last sea, though. Essentially, we're trying to get across the sea on a pirate ship, and we met Faria and her gigantic lightning beast, Sylvas or Sylvias. So, yeah, we're about to embark on a epic journey. So let's see where it takes us next. I need to remember whenever I'm doing these that the upload actually does at the end. So kind of like the timing of everything kind of flows better. My hindsight. What am I going to remember? Uploading. Our last save is uploading.
Chapter 9. The low seas.
Dude, the seas hang low. Can you swing them to and fro? Can you tie them in a knot? Can you tie them in a bow?
Okay,
no, you
so
never
like,
get this feeling if you hang up in the sea. No, you never get this feeling if your balls hang low.
Find that valley of fire.
Well, I don't know. Are we really just going to follow some random prophecy word for word? But what other leads do we have? Fine. I guess
okay.
We'll run with it.
Wait, huh? Stop asking what? Questions. Let's just
Captain
do it.
Ferris,
you know what I mean?
Can you
like
tell us
most
how
of this
get
game
to
is
the
done,
low
we
seas?
Just like let it flow and just take part.
Perhaps. But I'll not be lending you this ship. For one, she can't venture down sea, even if I were
okay.
feeling generous.
Okay, any particular reason why?
Ah, wait. Ahoy! Mog! Is our guest still aboard?
Guest, Koopa?
You know who. Oi. The
lass
in
glasses. Who's this?
Oh, from the league, Koopa. She might be Koopa. I'll go look, Koopa.
Please be if I fancy a character. I want to see if I fancy a character. Is it?
You
it's
need something?
Fucking Quistus, yes! Fucking knew it was. You got the quest. Yeah.
Sorry.
Oh, yeah, grooving along now.
I thought we were done with our transaction. Did you find some sort of problem with the cargo?
No.
Always wanted to hear what she sounds
sound.
Like.
I have another quandary, if you'll hear me out.
What's that?
These gents here have business in the low seas. Who are they? The giants from the hills. In the flesh.
What?
Ta-da!
Cut that out!
Sorry about Lon. I guess we might be the giants from the prophecy, but honestly, we don't know.
Ta-da! So after a moment's explanation... Yay!
Very
Christy!
So, they need a boat.
I have a thing for her.
And as I recall, you...
Derm will make passes at all the girls who wear glasses.
If it's true about the Thane, that he's some kind of monstrous Bahamutian doppelganger, then we don't owe him anything. Which means that the boat is up for grabs.
That sounds like a plan.
Aye.
Wait, up for grabs?
Steal the ship!
What do you mean?
Oh, my group had some business to attend to in Saronia. So we presented the Thane with a boat. Some might call it a bribe.
You don't need to wheel in the deal with a bunch of no-good monsters like that.
My
yeah.
group?
You're not even listening.
Yeah.
So you're absolutely certain. You saw the Thane undergo a transformation.
I want my squalls.
Hi.
I want my Sylphies.
Silver, let him have
how
it.
How many of them are going to be in it?
Okay.
Is Zell going to be in here?
Me wrong.
Oh, man.
I can see that they're giants.
Seifert? Seifert actually a good guy in this?
Got some
I'm curious
up
about
to
him.
Do. Do you think they'll survive the trip?
Oh, man.
One splash in the low seas can't stop us.
Ah, yay.
Well, I guess you win. You can take the fast craft
fast
down
craft.
To the low
nice.
Seas.
Oh, sweet!
Thank you so much!
Although, that whispering wasn't very encouraging.
She does spend a lot of time inside her own head. But I'm glad she is,
okay.
does because nobody
come
else bloody does.
Ready.
You ready?
I'll take you to the boat.
Okay, do we need to do anything? Do you know what we need to do? We have to take a moment to actually jump into our Mirage board because we have got a butt ton of points in the last chapter for a bunch of characters, and some of these are actually, of course, characters that we haven't actually used at all yet. So I want to know if there's anything worthwhile grabbing. We'll deal with the ones that we, of course, are using in our stacks, but we'll see who else is there as well. Yeah, so Tama has 6 points to spend and magic plus. Don't know what we need to do that, but we'll see. Magic plus, magic defense, magic plus. Blank space, accuracy, agility, critical. So, I think we'll just go magic plus first, and we'll take some agility, which will make us a lot harder to knock over, I imagine. And then we'll probably take critical, and then we'll fill out the rest as we need. Yeah, sound about right? Although, magic plus just means I could do more damage automatically. Yeah, I mean, from what I noticed is that the knockdown, the toppling, isn't really that common of a thing unless you're actually like going up against bosses, and I can manage it normally, but with the magic plus I can just pummel through everything with magic. I mean, I think fire is going to be probably one of the most powerful things that we have in this, so stacking for Fira is what my plan was anyway. So who else we got here? We of course have our, what will be Valifor, which would be awesome to get at some point, but we have 12 points to spend? Whoa! Okay, so Asuna, Deathbeak. Ooh, physical poison death? Yes, we want that. So how much do we need? 3, 4, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, so we're definitely going this route. Asuna, Stasium, once we've gone. Deathbeak, so we can poison death with bad boys. Evasion, accuracy, agility. 13 and more. So we're already at the right level for this, so we just need to get there. So 3, 6, 9, 10 before we can get anything else. So evasion, let's appear again. Safety bit. Yeah, I'm going to go with continuing on towards our path. Oh no, actually this. HP, just in case. That's one of the things where I'm starting to feel a little bit cautious about the amount of damage my characters are taking with the HP. It gives me a safety buffer. So we know we need, what, another 3, 6, 9, 10 before we can go to that. And, oh, I can actually turn this one into Valifor if I want to. So yeah. Cool beans. Who else do we need to sort out? We need to sort out Spankhand. God, I forget the names of these characters. They're terrible. Wow, that's right. To become that, we need to be 25 or higher, so no point really thinking about going that direction. We can get Thunder, so we need 2, 3, and then Thunder. All the characters will have Thunder. Yeah. Yeah, we're going this way. Evasion and a Thunder Jewel. So now, of course, we have Thunder for our characters. Got 2 points left to spend, so I'm trying to find something that's actually 2 points to spend on. I'm not going to spend on Joyride. I want to spend on another blank space. So, I suppose we have to wait really for the next one, unless I want to go with blank space and actually put in custom ability. Let's see what we got here. We can start using custom abilities where we have these, like Blizzard, Water, Cure, HP plus, Strength plus. I haven't had any need so far to use ice damage, except for that one time when I was looking for Blizzard to actually be able to Prism Tunity somebody. But it would be nice to have at least one that we can use, because I mean, no matter what, I'm going to have Thunder now with my characters, so this guy kind of has to have a secondary function, really. Strength, HP, Blizzard. Yeah, screw it, I'm going to go with Blizzard. Yep, so now I have Blizzard as well as a skill. So that's my stacks made as it is, but we need to take a look into our characters that have leveled up while we weren't paying attention. So I'm going to take a look at Chesty LaRue, because obviously Mimic was one of the weirder ones that we got during that mission. First strike, so he's got to spend 4 on that, and you got to spend 2 on that, so we've got Armor Piercer and... Oh, Bypass Defense? That'll be interesting. No escape, arcane counter, enter counter stance and retaliate against magical attacks. Yeah, but you have to actually use that move rather than actually being a passive. Siphon, that might actually be useful to have, so we need to work our way towards that. So we're probably going to ignore all the ones on this side. Unlock some kind of transfiguration to do that. So 2 here, and we can get counter. And then we're left with two left, which isn't going to be of any use to us for anything else for the moment. But if I feel like putting him in, at least now I can actually take physical counters. George, we're probably going to get rid of him fairly soon, but might as well see what he's got for his 12 points. Jump it in here. Cast to cast water. Joyride, we're not going to go for you. Salt. Oh, nice. I like that. Critical accuracy. And water spout. So I'm probably never going to use him, though. That's the only problem with him being a medium. So I already have a pretty decent medium in the Balafor character. Or the Sizzle Reel, as I keep calling it. That's the name I gave him. So we've got 3 points left. Ooh, strength. I'm going up around this way. So what else we got here? Take a look at our chickabee. See what we can do with our chickabee. Yeah, we can go to Chocobo for a large, actually. Oh, and that's right, I have the black choco chick too. So let's go for HP 3 and unlock the black chocobo board. So then I can jump in here. And one for that, and then chocobo. Boom! Yeah, so now I can actually transfig this into Chocobo. I still have 2 points left, but should I probably check in on Chocobo Kick, Joyride. I mean, it forced me to take Joyride, so I'm going to use up one of my points anyway. So, let's see. Accuracy Jewel would be useful. Raise. Oh, shit, yeah. Proper decent healing. Strength. I don't even know what that one is. I'm probably assuming it's actually like gold chocobo or something. So yeah, we'll just jump in and grab Joyride for now. So I can transform this one into a chocobo. I'm probably going to do that and then switch them into a large roll. Just simply for the cash gain that I get from it, the gil gain. And who else is here? Oh yeah, let's see if we're anywhere closer to getting this guy as far as being Shiva. Magic HP, Ice Storm. We want to go this way anyway. Can't do anything with that just yet. And we only got one left. Excuse me, but the voice is actually getting a little bit rough already. After that, we have a behemoth to take a look at. Oh, nice! Revenge Blast. Boom, boom, boom. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 4, 5, 6, 7. Yep, so let's go this way. That way I'm prepared for whenever this guy levels up and I can actually jump across to being a transfigured character. This is going to be fun. I've got plenty of these all sorted out. I know what I'm doing, I think. Oh god, the Mog? I haven't even touched him yet. Oh! So he does turn into the pirate one. Ah, Kapirate. Cool. So, magic, wind rhapsody. Oh, wind damage, right, cool. So, enhanced cure. That's going to be important. We'll go over that. And, what's this? Cure, merge. Also, we can actually give them cure to use. I don't know why I hadn't gone for this already. But, 3, 3, 2, 3, 1. If I use 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, so go this way. So... two... three, four... yeah. And... prepare it. Yeah, unlocked. And I still have four left to spend. Can I go in? I can actually go in and look, go to this board already, so... improves the effectiveness of HP recovery items. Damn right, that's gonna be useful. Yeah, man. This is... oh, yeah. Jesus Christ, the actual, like, the Mog has a fairly... extensive kind of, like, he does, like, multiple different, he actually has, like, multiple different kind of, skill sets. Like, actually has, like, different, elementals, which is great. That's really useful. What ones am I weak against? Darkness and ice, that's it. Fair enough. Works for me. No points left, so I'll be done and dusted with the Moogle. Is that everyone pretty much covered now? Except for Field Evil. I'll just go in here. So 3, 6, 7. So... so I think we'll go down this way and then we'll work our way around. So 3... raise magical defense. We've got none left really to go in here, so that's undone dusted. Okay, so that's all of the ones that I had in there, all covered. Mirror jewels need to be probably fitted in for characters. Who has the chocobo on them? Remember? So Lan has chocobo, so she's the one that, so Rin is the one that still needs Libra. Oh, awesome. So I'll give her the thunder jewel and give him the cure jewel. And that should have me covered for healing for both the characters. Which is awesome. Bam! Done and dusted. Okay, I thought that was going to take a little bit longer, but I'm glad I actually got that out of the way so I can be ready to rock and roll. So let's go talk to Questy. Yes, I am.
Okay, right this way.
I like her voice. God, I like speed, the gents. I like the girl they got to play Questus. That's awesome.
Oh, right. Where's my manners? Sorry we tried to rob you.
We really didn't mean to
cause
you
trouble. Yeah, fine, lads.
You can make it up to me. Perhaps. If you survive.
This sounds like what's going to be like the post-game quest if she doesn't hang around for otherwise.
This way.
So, Questus, who we got? Who's in the party? I'm just excited to see, because I want to see Squall just be dismissive and a prick. Selfie to be overly excited, and everybody else
Wait,
to be exactly as
where
they
does
are.
That road go? It's the way back to town. I mean, isn't that how you got here? The other road is crawling with mirages. Nobody uses that one anymore.
Dude! Oh, I so wish we knew about that coming in.
Well, that figures. I thought something about these docks smelled fishy.
But at least we found some good the mirages. No worries, the right?
Yeah, nope.
Oh, Perlan.
Here
yes,
she is.
Yes, yes.
Just give me a sec. I set the helm to autopilot, so it'll take you
right
to
Losey. That's cool, but it's also the fact it's a ship from the Dalet mission at the very beginning
of
the film.
The rest of the Federation catch on.
Wow, you're just as nice as a peach.
You're nice as a peach.
Thank you for everything.
But she's got a hard, stony center.
Bye now. Don't come back and haunt me.
Huh?
Come back and haunt me? Oh, Quistus. You're a sweetheart.
Well, at least it's starting to warm up.
Ah, yeah. The breeze is really nice. I can't believe they loaned us this great boat!
Yeah.
We really lucked you out this time.
Even more surprised that we're actually, like, styled on top of it.
You don't even have to steer it. I love the easy life.
But, Lon... Aren't you just a little worried about what Ferris and Quistus said?
What did they say?
Now that you mention it, they did kind of make it to sound like we weren't going to live out the day.
Pretty much.
I was like to find out whether or not we survived.
I wonder why.
What's so bad about
the sea? Underneath the sea, right?
We're just going south, right? You know, somewhere lower down on the map or something.
What if they're called low because of all the low lights living there?
No, it's low because it's the sea under the sea.
That could be it.
Hey, rain?
This boat is sinking.
Huh?
Is it just me, or is the river getting more whooshy?
You think so?
Rain? All of a sudden, I'm suddenly getting this really bad sudden feeling.
Yeah.
Me too.
Bad feeling?
About the
what?
Sea. That's what I'm thinking. Mort! More cutscenes!
Oh, wow.
Note to self.
Those seas are not south.
The low seas are not south.
What the honking heart?
They are literally straight down!
Awesome. I'm appreciating these little moments. Happy Tama. They just let they lost the boat.
Jelly
Is that a
sandwich?
How are we alive?
Tama, you still with us?
Never been the better.
The better.
But, hey, don't do that on my
head. Don't shake. You're going to make my head hurt more. Okay, so saving progress. Apparently, was that a chapter? I don't know. I think we're going to not call that a chapter. We're going to let this roll on for a little while longer. I'm assuming it's just like a mini save point. All right, let's see. Where do we go next? Oh, again with the upload. I should turn that off, actually. So don't even think about that. The save data on your system is being copied to the server. To avoid corrupting your save data, do not touch the PS button or power button. Yay, we're there. Try and get our bearings. I like the happy little rainbow.
Now that our boat's busted, how are we supposed to get where we're going?
Don't ask me.
Oh, hello there. Okay, they didn't seem to be very happy to see us.
Those Mirage the Meanies have flipped that toy little mini mansion over!
Man toys?
Can you get it? Hey, come down! Nobody likes a bully!
Looks like you snakes need to be taught a lesson!
Oh, so tempted to use Deathbeak. But first, I need to find out what the hell they are. Okay, no, fuck that. I'm gonna go Deathbeak. Boom! Didn't work. Alright, never mind then. Because I should have Libra now on both characters, yeah? Oh, I thought I had Libra on both characters. Oh well. Cat Claw! I was wondering there for a second, I thought they were going to be ridiculously horrible, but they're not. So, yeah, let's take a look at the sea snake. See what their weaknesses actually are. Like, thunder. Thunder? Really? You're going to beat the crap out of them. And water attacks to create a prism opportunity. I don't think I have any water attacks on my characters as it is at the moment. So we'll see. Ailments, they can't be poisoned. Oh, they can be poisoned. They can't be put to sleep, is it? No, they're perfectly fine. They're weak against a couple of things. Confusion and something else. We'll see. So yeah, thunder. Bye. Whoa! He survived the thunder, even though... Oh, wow. Okay. Huh. That was mildly surprising. Oh, okay. Well, my characters are actually weak against water, so that's not a good sign. Do I have any... Oh, I love the fact that I actually have Cura now as well, because they stacked. Do I have any... That's ice. I don't have any water. Let's just right claw them. Yeah, not too bad. Like 400. Well, no, 140 plus 100. 340. Asuna, cure, fire, and thunder. Well, it looks like I'm not going to be able to capture any of these guys for the moment because they don't have the appropriate attacks.
No trouble at all.
Predictable.
Sorted. Oh, nice. I'm actually liking the EXP boost now. So each location really does have a substantial rise in XP. Imagine that's used so that you can power level characters up if you don't have one that are strong enough.
Huh, looks like even mirages have to put up with mean old bullies.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
Rain, come on.
Huh? What?
We're mirage keepers. If you're gonna let them just swim away, then you're doing exactly the right thing.
Hello, Adamant Toys.
Mew!
Hmm? Oh.
Young Mirage Keepers, my Mini Mantis here tells me that you saved his life.
Mew!
I thank you.
I think that's great!
It talked with words!
Oh, I'm talking the Mirage!
Why not?
Seriously?
No. Tell me
keepers
what a pair
like you
of keepers
are doing
like
all the way out here.
All the way out here.
Well.
Then.
Then I shall help you find this babble. You are free to ride.
Much appreciated, man.
Dude!
Awesome.
Are you sure?
Oh, yes. I'll be your fast craft. Or my best approximation of what a fast craft is.
As I have no idea. Okay, that's weird. Okay, sure. Let's rock and roll. No reason to question it. Just let's rock and roll. The mega shark whales of the low sea are mega deadly. It's very unlikely you'll be able to defeat one the first time you encounter them, so you might want to steer clear for now and come back when you're stronger. Okay. So I have to avoid them?
Now, off we go. I know little about the world.
So it's like just a dodging game now?
Something swimming around over there.
I don't like the look of it one the bit.
Why not?
Mega shark.
Vaughn? Does this not remind you of anything?
Hey, let's try touching it.
Please don't.
Oh, please don't.
Oh, I want to touch it.
Huh?
What?
Whoa.
That has to be Titus.
What was that?
Oh.
No.
Real actual people. I thought I might have been seeing things.
At least she's not talking to an owlbear.
Who are you? Oh,
hi, Riku.
My bad. My name's Riku.
Is she? She's in her Final Fantasy X-2 costume.
Man, I wish that Mirage hadn't come along and trashed my boat, because I was having a great day of treasure hunting.
What's the
goals? I'm a good swimmer, so it's no biggie. But I was really starting to get pooped. Then I spotted you guys sailing along on top of old Adamantus.
Adamantus?
Here.
Adamantois.
So, is there some story behind all this?
Always with the story.
The more the joyer. Enjoy the
peace. I like the feel
Thank
of
you.
Young women on my
Man,
back.
How totally
it's
awesome are you, Mirage Keepers?
A lovely
it can't be
feeling.
Easy befriending an Adamantus.
Honestly, I think we just happened to bump into a really nice one.
Hmm. Oh, so you're trying to get to the Babel region, right? You need to set a course that way.
It's the amazing convenience of tour guides that are appearing everywhere in this. It's beautiful. Okay.
So, shall we be on
Please.
Our way?
Off we go!
Take it away.
Let's go!
Which way do we go from here?
These guys.
Well...
Oh, that was close. mild panic there. How far do you go? avoid you. Oh, shit! No! Whoops! Okay.
What now?
Yep.
It's hostile! And really the strong!
That's not good. Yep. Guess what we're using? Yeah.
This is the man is the first ever of.
Seffy is my bishy, but let's hope this is actually powerful enough, because I'm a little bit concerned. Boom, boom, boom. Come on, please put him to sleep. Nope, that didn't work. Nope, we're dead. Done. Meh. Meh. At least we knew we survived, but that was kind of shitty. Do you know what? I'm going to go up to the promenade, and I think I'm going to change my...
If the one of your mirages has unlocked the joyride ability, you can hitch a ride on it as long as it's in your lineup. It might let you get around them more quickly. It might let you access some new of the places. It might help you find cool stuff. Or it might not let you do any of those things. Sometimes the joyride ability is just there because it's the fun. Give it a try and you might be the surprise.
Well, ain't that delightful?
You're here to manage your
Your Miss Prismariums. Oh, you're gonna change them around a little? Okay. Wait, the chocobo was only a medium? Oh man. I thought the chocobo was actually a large. Oh, damn.
Sometimes the joyride ability is just there because it's the fun. Give it a try and you might be surprised.
Ain't that delightful? So I'm going to go to the shop and take a look to see what there's in the chocolate latte mart. And, I mean, obviously I'm not going to have to avoid those sharks because there's no way I'm going to beat them. Like, I wanted 700 damage per hit from the side
the
guys.
Best is yet in store.
Yeah, they obviously warned me before.
Welcome to the chocolate...
I need to go grinding for anything. Oh, so drain... Sleep and confuse. Oh, wow, 30,000 though. It's kind of getting a little bit. But there is banish, which could be useful. Nothing there though where you want to grab. And 3,000 a pop. It's a bit expensive. Spider silk. Oh, this is actually for different effects. Chimeric wind. Moderate. So like some of the ones have gone from actually being like a light one to being a heavy or medium damage. Poison blindness is a remedy for all the stuffs. Spelling, stilts, and other things, high potions. Yeah. Not really anything else to worry about here at the moment because I haven't got a massive stack of stuff, but it's that's me pretty much covered. Choco Boco Bye. Everything's gonna be alright. Choco, choco, bye-bye. Oh, choco, bye. Does anybody else remember Sean Mullins? I'm pretty sure none of you do. White guy with guitar. I listened to that album way too much. Got really popular in the south of Ireland for, like, I think 2 or 3 weeks. He charted with Lullaby quite big over here, but for a very short period of time. Okie dokie, let's try that again. It's also odd that there's no save point there.
That was close.
Perhaps we took a long turn.
Dude.
Well, we're navigating, so we've got no one to blame but ourselves.
Did we turn wrong at Albuquerque? I know I was almost there.
Make me think of Vulturo as well from... I wouldn't be surprised if that is the voice of Vulturo from Harvey Birdman, Attorney at Law.
God damn it!
I thought I'd actually dodged it. Can we run from this fight?
Oops.
Come on!
What are you doing? Can we... No, please! Can we please escape?
Just kidding.
But what are we meant to do otherwise? Just die? God. Cat Claw. See if we can knock him out. Nope, that ain't very effective. Bam, dead. Bam, dead. So this is actually the first time I've actually ran into any issues while fighting in this. And obviously it's enemies that are far, far too strong to be taken on. But this is the first time I've actually like fallen and died in the game. Most of the times whenever I played RPGs, I always had an issue with dying in the game. Whenever it was actually like an immediate game over. Which was... it was frustrating in games, when, especially whenever I would have been doing stupid things like hardcore runs of a Final Fantasy game or any Square Enix game, really. But it came to a head with The Last Remnant and Infinite Undiscovery, which were two games that felt like they didn't bother with the indoctrination and explanation stuff of a game. Another one, Resonance of Fate, was another game that actually kind of had that same effect on it, where you're playing through the very early parts of the game and you could very easily die to the first fight that you ever run into. And it made me stop playing the games, even though I still have the game, I still own them. But I never wanted to go back and play them just to kind of get past that point and actually see what the plot was, because I didn't have the hook, didn't get the story hook that would actually held me forever enthralled with the game series or with the plot of the game. And in this, because they very clearly lay out, like, you can't die in this, it feels the same effect that I would have had whenever I was playing, say, oh, come on! Same thing I had whenever I was playing Pokemon, where whenever you black out and you just wake up at the nearest Poke Center and you work your way back from there. In this case, it's literally teleporting you back at the moment before you die. So, yeah, let's see how much defense works. Because I can still get killed by one hit from these guys. Well, defense actually doesn't stop from dying. Wow, even the wee side guys are actually pretty damn powerful too. Yeah. We will not be doing. So whenever they joke about them being really ridiculously strong, they are really ridiculously strong. Boom! Oh, didn't kill me in the one hit. Surprised. Oh, stop delaying the inevitable. Yes, the party has fallen. Whatever. So, obviously, you can see the difficulty curve isn't big in this game from the way I've been playing through chapters so far, but to have something like this to literally be the reason why I can't move forward can be unbelievably frustrating. I'm like, I'm not going to get to all ragey, shouty, whatever else, but this is draining my will to actually like try and do what we're planning to do with the marathon and get through this as fast as possible, because all it is, I'd be better off if they just attacked me as soon as they appeared and I died, or I just rebooted every single time they attacked me rather than me having to go for the point of getting into one of those fights. Quite frustrating.
Sit back and enjoy the ride.
Really?
Aye, aye.
Oh, God damn it. Oh, God damn it. Did you notice that he stopped for me? The prick. Ring-a-ding-ding. Woosa, woosa, soft coming breaths. We may. We're not losing our shit here. It's gonna be fine. It'll be just fine. I don't have that in me anymore to rage and decry video games in a very, very overt manner. But the things can twist my nipples. They can twist my nipples. It's also the fact that the choice of transport is unbelievably slow. Why? Yeah, you gonna turn? Yeah, you gonna turn? God damn it, turn! There we go. The widest berth is actually the gap in between the two of them whenever they pass. Whoa, Nelly. What the fuck? They just changed their pattern? Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. Oh, god damn you fucking sharks. What the fuck? Are they actually truly random? No, fuck off! Crisscross whatever the fucking way you like, but keep it consistent, you shark-faced prick. I'm coming back here whenever I'm high leveled, and I am beating these fucking things to death with the tip of my cock. Right, let's try that again. Right. Just checking there was no other way, just by random chance, I might be like, teleport to the middle part where you already met Riku. Because we're still going to have to go through that bit again as well. Thank god I know how to skip dialogue scenes. I have no idea whether or not he's going to stop. There we go. Opportunity seized. Oh, you fuck. Have we lost Riku?
Oh?
Then what is it?
Okay. Welcome to the Rainbow Shore, obviously, but, no Riku scene? Oh, wait, has she disappeared?
Chapter 10. Too warm. Well, yippee!
With us, Riku?
Thanks for all the help.
Nonsense. No trouble.
Yes, I got a young woman.
Thanks
after
for showing us the way, Riku. No problem.
You know how hard an adamant choice is.
So, yes. Where are you headed from
yes,
here?
She shall.
Hey, there's this place I've been trying to reach. Would you mind if I hitched a ride a bit longer?
Of course.
Sure, I must head back myself. Not a problem.
Thanks a bunch. Okay, then. Back to my regularly scheduled, totally awesome treasure hunting.
And again, post-game content.
And be careful. See ya!
Bye, Adamantus!
It's not Adamantus. Adamantoys! Like, turtoise. Jesus!
Right, so...
It's not even just the basic level of stupid that I'm worried about now. This is actually mispronunciations.
Be the careful. Whatever's up ahead, it's causing my Mirajadar to go bonkers.
I'm going to take a wee look here, because it seems to be like a big open space here for no apparent reason, other than to hide a chest. That's what it makes me immediately think. There is a chest hiding here somewhere. Yes? No? Maybe? I don't know. Can you repeat the question? You're not the boss of me now. You're not the boss of me now. You're not the boss of me now, and you're not so big. Yes. I did like Malcolm in the Middle back in the day. I also liked the band as well that wrote the song. Well, isn't this delightful? A valley of death! There's a lot of these doors.
You don't want to take a spill down these, the cliffs!
Oh, come on. How old do you think me and Rain are?
Hey, Lon. Slapstick's less funny if you die from it. Let's make this good.
Okay. So, Copper Gnome. We've already dealt with Copper Gnome before, haven't we, right? We don't need to capture any more of those. So we can just go thunder. I'm assuming that's kind of like almost like a glacial eye, or unless it gets a fire version of it, or it's the whatever variety that exists within this area. Down you go. Oh, yes. So cool. Here we go, solo, that's how you got you. Boom, caught, captured, ready to rock and roll. Fabulous.
Well, I can imagine that how much he
replaces our, like, flawed evolution. What is this? What's he called? What's the name? Burning blood red eye that slings around fire magic. Kind of looks like a flying tomato. Rumor has it its tears are the secret ingredient at Greymoor's best watering holes. Essentially, he's got fire water for tears. Yep. Blood eye, that's what he's called. Okay. So, abilities. So, blood eye is not connected to the other one that I have that's kind of like a bat creature with an eyeball in the center. Slightly weird. Fire, gaze, lithion, gaze, flutter, blank space, blaze spikes. Ooh, he has reflect. Yep, guess what you're replacing. What should I name him as well? So, blood eye, I don't know. I was thinking pink eye, but he's not quite pink, he's more of a red. So, oh, I'm trying to think of someone that's actually, like, possibly to do with penises and peeing fire. I think I will call him STD Bob. Hi there, STD Bob. Why does it hurt when I pee? Why does it hurt when I pee? I caught it from a toilet seat. Take the Mirage with you? Yes, we shall. We'll take the STDs with us. And we'll get rid of our failed evolution. Oh, wait, what? Huh? I'm not using them for... Oh, it'll affect the stacks for characters I'm not using. Yeah, that's probably fine. I think I might actually set up the stacks for the other characters that I've, the other version I'm not using. So, she needs a large. I only have the one anyway, so that doesn't fucking matter. Problem solved! And he needs a medium, so we can just throw him in there. Problem solved. STD Bob!
Treacherous.
Ah, right. I was wondering how I was going to get across there, but I need to flutter across and then drop back down again.
I won't hold back.
Thunder. Thunder. Thundercats. Ho! It does the job easy.
Yeah!
Blood Eye! This is exactly what it says in the tin. Bleeds. I'm getting a fair amount of cash now, so I could probably start spending a little bit more on higher level items.
Yeah, watch your step, or you. What the? Oh!
Wow, it's even funnier the second time.
Oh, the poor girl. Oh no, that's right, because I took away my flutter. Yeah, so let's hopefully the Mirage. Well, let's hope Flutter is one of his first skills. Probably is. Like, they tend to force that one as soon as. Yep, bam, sorted. We'll come back to you later whenever we possibly might be using you. So I'm thinking if I can get a stack of three fire on top of each other, I'm going to get the Firaga. And I can whomp anything that actually has, even, like, not a weakness to it, but, you know, has. Doesn't have a resistance to it. Shit, even some stuff that has resistance. Well, that was a bit of a trip for two Phoenix Stones, but whatever. Make ourselves a little bit more comfortable, a little bit more presentable for camera. Last one across the cliff. So well, if we go this way, I'm assuming there's actually a flutter.
Which yep. would make you one strange dragon.
Something about a strange dragon? I don't know. Whoa! Whoa! What the fuck?
You then need to learn to exploit your Mirage's elemental resistances.
You want us to blow them up?
That's explode, and while I'd love to give you credit for the first four letters, you clearly weren't listening.
Yeah.
I was listening. They're mental resistors.
Man.
Ugh, that's clearly
yeah,
what you thought.
Yeah, you've got issues, dude. We need to switch up the stacks a little bit here because I need to have at least some form of... Alright. I'm going to jump on the Mirage board. And I'm going to jump onto his and see if there's any... See, he'll have water harmony. See, he has water right there. I need two for it. Ah, man. What I wouldn't give just to have that skill right now. But wait. Can I go in here? That's the thing I'm curious about. Do I carry over abilities along with whenever I switch to another... Yeah, it does. I carry over the abilities. Although I lose some of them. I lost Wind Rhapsody. And the Moogle can flutter as well. That was weird. Why did I have to actually use your man to flutter? Oh man. I really, really want to have Q-Pirate kind of kick his ass for me, but I need to switch to somebody else. So essentially, I'll probably need to throw you. And take from Mergules. Is there any more of them that I have? Have they gone? Yeah, Thunder Defense. I'm trying to think of like what I can do to actually make this guy my bitch in the shortest way possible because I just saw a giant dragon sitting there. I know I've said I wanted to do side stuff, but this is not really side stuff. Mog Station, you jump off there and let's give Snowboy a try. Strength way down. But let's jump in. See what is anything I can get for the 2SP because I'm pretty sure I. with someone else. Whoa, what the hell? Yeah, Mog. Off. And let's see, Mirage Board for you. Blizzard. Ice Storm, I do have Ice Storm. Awesome, that's great. I don't have enough for Enhanced Ice or Magic Defense. But I do have Blizzard and Ice Storm. So let's make use of that and kick his ass. Do I actually have any kind of elemental resistance to fire because of these two? So it'd be nice if she was actually defended too. I'm gonna take it that she does. I mean, both of them are actually fire characters, so she won't take as much hit. She can focus on healing while he focuses on just dumping blizzards on him. Oh shit,
okay,
there's two of them!
Here we go.
Well, I won't hold back. And I don't have a save as well for this, so I hope. Well, I mean, at least it does it to the beginning of the chapter. Yeah, Red Dragon, let's find out. I assume Red Dragons are fire. This is one of those assumptions you make whenever you're looking at games. Okay, so he absorbs fire completely. Ice and water, minus 50. Bam, I've got you done. I've got you beat, lad. I've got you beat. Yep, so abilities. And I have Blizzara as well. Excellent. So inflict magical ice damage, inflict magical ice damage. Which one's more powerful? Ice Storm or Blizzara? Screw it, Blizzara it is. Boom! Yep. We need to land a critical to actually do the damage, but got some beat anyway, either way. No, we're not going to do any of that. So, no, none of that's going to work. Maybe, maybe, that might actually... That'd be fucking hilarious if I actually took it out in one hit. Ice Storm hits both of them! These guys are pretty damn easy, actually. Damn it! Was I so critical too? Man! I'm trying to get a critical out of you, man. Nope. Whoa. Damn it. Killed both of them without even getting the chance. It was worth it for the EXP, but I'm really disappointed that I didn't manage to actually get, hopefully get a memento. But they don't change, they change the music for the mementos. That's a problem.
Ugh, that's clearly what you've got!
What can you do? Didn't get myself a red dragon. Which would have been nice, but, to get a critical right on the one that knocked him out. That's a bit shitty. So where are we going? We are going this way. Got a wild feeling there that that was actually going to be a mimic trap. Just because of the giant dragon face that's in the world. There's a lot of dragon faces and everything here.
Right, let's do this!
Here
Maybe
we
just,
go!
Maybe just the natural topography of the world is just naturally dragon head. So, hit that one, that should do the job. He's going to do Ice Storm. Oh shit, they resist ice. That's annoying. It's actually better just to punch them in the end up. Oh, shut up. I should have probably left that and let myself get healed, but remember that for the next round. Right, I have Blizzard because I taught Blizzard to... Oh, I'm so glad I actually put Blizzard onto that guy now that I actually have Babilish on it. But I'll be disappointed that I've actually like abandoned ship with Mog, but I can already cure. That's a big deal. Well, I can't do mass curing, which is a problem. Alright, I'm just going... Like I was about to say, like I can backtrack and get that crit. Nah, not worth it.
Okay, here we go.
Boom! Almost full heal. Sweet. Ow. And down you go. Ow. Stop looking at me like that.
Well, that ought to do
all
it.
Right.
I miss the coupeau at the end whenever they always go, kippah! Mildly disappointing. What can you do? Well, admittedly, this mine's got its own section.
So, Tama, could you tell us more about exploiting resistances?
Kaboom!
Would you stop?
It's all about the kaboom. Explodo! Ah! No! Ah, damn it. Didn't even open the crate, I have to go back again. You unfair bastards!
But if you put...
Let's try that again. Well, that was mildly useful. You can...
reduce the damage you take from flames.
Oh, yeah, so I suppose, I mean, essentially I'm prepared for flame protection. Gimme! What do you need?
Gimme!
Fluffy feather?
Pika knows how to play defense.
I guess we'll have to give it what it wants.
Dude.
See, this is a bit that's actually annoying me. I don't enjoy doing these kind of, like, searchy bits.
What? The element...
Like, this does actually feel like a bit of a chore, kind of running around getting this crap for the gimme stones.
For sure. Basically, we need...
Whoa!
So I'm assuming Lan shocked the life out of them by understanding about elemental resistances of actual individual mirages.
What?
You're the right!
Somehow you understood...
Oh, more dragons! Well, there we go. Opportunity number two.
Let's make this good.
Dude, it's on.
Fuck are those? Do they actually have any legs? Buy Hydra Stack. Oh, right. So it's kind of like the two-head ones and then Spark Dragons. All right. So, Deathbeak. Oh, crap, I missed. Okay, so we need to actually knock some shit down. You know what? Ice Storm on all three of them. Yep, perfect. Eat. Only knows how low his health was. These guys are getting stronger, but not really killing me either. thunder on the light hydra stack. Yeah, oh, I'm being poisoned. That's the reason why I was wondering. My health was dropping way too quickly. I was going like, why? I'm all right. Well, let's see. What do we need? We'll have ourselves a spark dragon. Status healings. All right. Never a second going, Jesus. Very long delay for the attack. Do I have any... I mean, Death Peak would have done it, but if it actually had hit anyone.
We did it!
Oh yeah!
So I wonder what Spark Dragons become. Oh, I could have thrown one of the status effect items. There you go. That's why I bought those.
That much is the obvious.
Oh yeah, the dragon.
No one.
So let's use some healthy items. Get ourselves nice and ready. So one for you, one for you. And then go to fight these guys.
No one in her right.
I kind of want a red dragon just because of the size of them. They look kind of cool. Oh, no ice storms. Well, that's going to be fun. Just attack. They're classy guys, they're only just throwing the headbutts in, they're just dipping the head in with those horns. We're keeping this all civilized fisticuffs at the moment. Come on! Whoa! Christ almighty again! Say, might be worthwhile time to actually drop a cure on that guy. Yep, done and dusted. Come on, just give me a critical. Wow. So expecting the last one to be a critical again. Could very well be. No, didn't even get on that one.
Well, that ought to do it.
I should probably just draw, like, go for some, like, critical plus or something, but... I think we'll be fine without. We don't have a red dragon, it's not the end of the world.
No one in her right mind would...
Yay! Exactly what I was looking for.
No one in her right mind would put Lon and Wise in the same sentence.
Searching. We continue our search. Nope, not a fluffy flower. So, ladies and gentlemen, how are you enjoying yourselves? Are you enjoying the stream? Are you enjoying the video here on youtube.com/PasticheofSkin? Don't you feel relaxed? It's such a chilled out, filled out atmosphere where we just kind of keep going and going. Come on. So I'm assuming the gimme stone is blocking an alternate route, or I'll have to actually go through and come back.
Alrighty, whoa. Let's go.
Come on, break.
I don't want single attacks. I don't want you to have multiple attacks. So, yeah. Let's see here. Fuck it. Just go to go and attack. Go straight into attack. And you're the one who does all. Just attack something. Go for that one. Yay! down. Two down. And here comes the last one. Damn those dragons, man.
That wasn't so bad.
Yeah, screw it. I'm actually going to use my abilities to do the cures. Does he still have the cure? Nah, he doesn't. He's just realizing that each one of them that actually has cure can be used individually. Yeah, I'll just use items. I was looking out there and going like, it's not worth it for the AP that I have left. Let's rock and roll. So at some point, I'm going to get a critical hit on one of these goddamn dragons. Fuck me. Attack because there's no other chance. Oh no, that's not good. This essentially means that I'm not going to have to spend all my time curing him. Typical. Right. Oh man, she's like super reduced down to just only having one attack, really. Oh, are you serious? Yeah, screw it. I'm gonna actually use... Oh, no, I don't... I want to keep my champions for whenever I actually have a boss fight to go, because they tend to actually just like finish a boss fight for me really easily. He was weak and that still didn't do any damage to him? Fuck it. Don't care. You know what, I'm actually like, I'm not even too concerned about actually getting hit badly with that. I think I got hit badly for it like once. That's been like critical. There it is! You are my- oh, yeah, I was about to say, you are mine. You are now also mine. Oh god. There we go. So. We have a red dragon!
Good fight.
Woo! That was worth it. Well, I mean, it didn't take a long roundabout route. That was the only way I was going to really do the damage to them quickly enough anyway, but yeah, it was worth it. Oh, so that's what the spark dragon becomes. Oh, there you go.
A type of dragon found all throughout the dragon scars. It may look slow, but that's all muscle. In addition to its physical prowess, its fire is hot enough to melt anything. Of course, you have to wonder, were those legs hiding in the spark dragon's cloud all along?
No, they weren't. They were just like figments of your imagination. So, Flare Star, Red Fang, Fire Breath, Blaze Spike, Smash, Fira. So yeah, damn, that's awesome. So I'm going to be changing her up to stacks that I can throw. I'm probably get rid of. I'll probably get rid of. Possibly. I'm wondering if it's actually like worthwhile, kind of like switching him in. I might try. I'll see what I can do with it because I lose my triple stack with and all the sizzle and all those kind of things, but he's still in my like group otherwise, so it might still be worthwhile having him around. the Balafor, because I'm going to essentially like, keep leveling that up until it's Balafor. Sizzle reel. Keep on forgetting the names of the characters that I have in this. So, Red Dragon. What do we call a Red Dragon? For some reason, just the name Clancy popped into my head, but I want to actually give him a name, something that's befitting of his horned goddess or godliness. Let's see. Yeah, Charizard. That's right, that makes sense for me. Charizard. And I'm going to take you with me. And I can probably drop some of these goddamn medium-sized ones that I have sitting around here. So, George, get the fuck out of my house, George. A little middly. Yeah, George would have been water resistance, really. I was sitting thinking, like, would he have been worthwhile having in this situation? Nope, wrong way. Gotta backtrack. Do we? God, no. I don't think it's worth it. That's what it is. It's just like, going, like, no, not gonna backtrack. Nearly every dungeon has a secret area just waiting to be discovered. Rare mirages often lurk in these well-hidden spots. You may not have the right tools to access a hidden area the first time you visit a dungeon. Try returning once you have a few more tricks up your sleeve. Well, the first one I found was the Black Choco Chick, and of course I failed to capture that son of a bitch, but I do have the memento, which then allowed me to... Whoa! Turn into... Shit. Well... Okay, is this kind of like Cerebus? Okay, fine, bring it on. Once more into the breach, dear friends, and ether, the book. So I actually have plenty of AP. Boom. Right. So, do you want, guys? So tempted to actually like take a break for this to actually jump in, but nah, fuck it, we're gonna go for it. Okay, this is a terrible idea, but he's so big.
Watch it, this will be a tough one.
Huh? Yeah, it will be a tough one. Abilities, Libra the fuck out of this. Because I'm pretty sure I'm not gonna be using any fire against this dude, but this is Cerebus.
Come on,
Cerebus the goddamn dog. So, damn it. Light is the only thing that he's actually weak to. Fire, ice, and thunder attacks to create a prism. Fire, ice, and thunder. So I have to use things he's actually strong against? Well, at least I actually have strong fire, strong ice, strong... Oh, yeah. This could actually be reasonably easy. Whenever I say reasonably easy, that's a bit of a stupid statement to make, but, I could probably do this. Alright, let's see what we got. If we go with Lazara. Boom. And then go with Vera. And then Thunder. Boom! And again with thunder. I'm gonna go for it. Nice!
All right.
That was not threatening or dangerous or bad in any way, shape, or form. That's awesome. That's my first extra large 25,000 EXP. Whoa! God damn! That's awesome. Wow. Okay. Yeah. On that bombshell, we're going to take a look at the character, but I am absolutely sure, and we're going to be taking a break right after this capture. But wow. Yeah, that's awesome. An extra large. So the white knack that I didn't bother getting previously, this is actually the extra large version of it. So yeah. All right. So Cerebus.
A huge mirage that attacks with three elements from its three heads, two of which strangely don't seem to be attached. A certain Mr. Valentine packs a gun named after this mirage, but neither he nor his weapons seem to be around.
Vincent Valentine, you're a gentleman.
Look at the fucking stats on that. Defense isn't bringing grand, but yeah. Oh man, what is the attacks it has? So, White Knack, I know what that is. Cerebus, Blaze, Ice Storm, Thunderbolt, Sonic Fangs. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. I'm liking that. That's awesome. That's my first extra large. What are we calling this dude? Fire Puppy? I'm thinking Fenrir, but he is Cerebus. How dare you actually rename Cerebus? I'm trying to think. Tripup? I'm thinking it. Tripup. Ah, some pup there, boy. Some pup. Tripup. Awesome. Yes, I will be taking that fucking mirage with me. Who can go fuck themselves? Like I said, I'm thinking like, maybe the behemoth? I don't know who decks to get rid of. It has to be one of the mediums, because essentially I've got small. But four smalls. 1, 2, 3, 4 mediums and 2 larges. Damn. I'm trying to think who's actually the least functionally useful to me. Mog's got a lot of healing. Behemoth is actually the least useful to me out of the bunch, so I'm sorry, dude, but you gotta go. Behemoth is gone.
Mega Mirages. Mega Mirages are extra large size mirages that are too big to put in your stacks. Instead, Lan and Rin can summon them in battle by expanding both their AP. Make no mistake, though, Mega Mirages are powerful enough to justify the cost. Your other mirages will be returned to the Prismariums while the Mega Mirage is present. Mega Mirages continue to fight until they run out of HP, or until Rin or Lan run out of AP. You can unsummon them before that happens, but be careful, because you won't be able to call on the Mega Mirage again for a little while.
Awesome, so I have the summons for I actually have like summons for them now. That makes sense, so I replace all of my Mirages with Cerebus if I call him in. That makes sense. That is so cool. Are you serious? So Cerebus was the guaranteed one that you were meant to get? Oh, I got overly excited about that secret areas and shit, and it's literally the only way you can progress with the game. Are you kidding me? Oh, that took a lot of that feeling of happiness away, man. Oh, you bastard. That's actually a really shitty move, game. I was all condemning, like, oh yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm probably not meant to fight this guy. I'll come get him later. No, do you know what? Actually, no, fuck it. I'm gonna do it now.
Right, let's do this.
Yeah, of course we're bringing our Tripop. You insane? Fusion! Ah!
Damn! Shit! He actually is pretty damn serious.
Are you what? What the fuck, man? That was all sorts of shit. And now I have to actually fight them hand to hand because I've got no AP left as well. That is bullshit. So the Mega Mirages aren't really that big of a deal, they're not that cool of a thing, because you need to have like a full stats and perfect stats to actually be able to mess with them. I mean, if you do it, you leave yourself unbelievably open to just getting whomped afterwards if you don't do any damage. Man. Yeah. So the champion summons are actually more powerful, I mean, because they're a definite one-hit, big hit. That's... man. I'm not cool with that. That was a really disappointing kind of anti-climax. Yeah. And now I need to finish this chapter as fast as humanly possible because a lot of things there just annoy the shit out of me. Yes, you get the full free fire. See where it would go if I go the other way. I actually have items I can pick up. Sorry, I think there's plenty of times where I just go completely silent to look at someone like, what the fuck are they trying to get me? Because I said you'd tempt you down to get the item, and then you have to do another lap around. And like I said, this chapter needs to finish itself quickly after that mild disappointment. Like, preemptive strike, fantastic. In that case, we attack. Die, you sons of bitches. And heal. Keep you up on your feet while the poison takes effect. My enthusiasm is like waning slightly. That was actually... Hey, what can you do?
No trouble at all.
That wasn't
after
so bad.
Having a nice burst of like, oh yeah, fuck yeah, awesome shit. And I'm like, no, it's kind of balls. I'm also noticing that I'm obviously not, because I'm not grinding, I've gotten past that kind of like first level of like one hit killing enemies. And I think I need to kind of like focus on keeping a stack the same for a while. So that, so whenever I keep a stack same for a while, so whenever I level up that stack, that they are obviously the more powerful ones that are actually going to be able to take enemies down very quickly if I'm going to try and do these rush sections. That was not really worth a high potion.
Slowly, we increase our strength, journeying up the cliffside, slowly making
Come
our
on,
way
bring
Let's
to
begin.
Our destiny.
Ice storm? There we go. Ow! And down you go.
Yeah!
Good job!
Right, come on. Now at this point, it's actually definitely getting like one of those feelings of like, I need to accelerate this a little bit. Oh, great! See a point. Why do I have the greatest feeling of not fear, but mild expectation that this is Phoenix? It looks fluffy like a Phoenix. I think it might be Phoenix. Pretty sure it's Phoenix. This is going to be Phoenix, isn't it? It's going to be Phoenix. Yeah, it's Phoenix.
Rain? Do you hear
or
something?
Or a much bigger dragon. Oh, shit.
Gosh. Who knew the winds of Babel could be so toasty?
Lon! Shrink now!
Holy mom bombs!
Holy mom bombs! Holy fucking shit, man! Bring it on, ya fire bitch!
Yeah, we all taste bad, but...
What about it?
He's just a slightly bigger version of the ones that we've been fighting the entire way through. So yeah.
Mega Red Dragon!
Yeah, you can't really do anything except for Deathbeak, so... Yeah, just gonna normal attack. That's all it's gonna be. Alright, that's it. Fuck off. Time to do the big hits. We've got three of these to use. Let's see how much damage we can actually pull off of them.
Dum 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 dum.
Bada 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 bum 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 bada bada bum. Whoa! That's a nice big critical hit, actually. Yeah, might as well hit him with another one. That only took about half the energy then. This, the fact that I actually just sped through that was actually a lot more enjoyable. Whoa! Oh, shit! Yeah. Why not? God damn it! Panicking there for a second to make sure I actually had enough to heal myself and get myself back up on my feet. But yeah, we're done. We're sorted. Okay, good and grand. As long as he doesn't do that big mad move again, we're okay for at least another turn. Okay, so what's his health at? I mean, I said you would be helpful if I probably checked that at some point. It's about a quarter, a bit more than a third left. I suppose it's worthwhile doing this. Big Zap! I don't know what I'm going to choose, but I think I'll go with Big Zam. Oh, so you can't skip Sephiroth's one, but you can skip the Warrior of Lights one? Which is a little bit odd. What do you think? I suppose because this is probably closer to being a cutscene than the Warrior of Light one is, because the Warrior of Light one actually involves the creature that you're attacking, and Sephiroth doesn't appear in the game at any other time otherwise. That's kind of smart. Fucking hell. Okay, so essentially he replies back with that. That was mildly terrifying. Alright, that feels a little bit better. Come on! Okay, so what are we moving on to now? Back to Blazara. We've used up all of our champions, so essentially now at this point, all I can do is attack. Do you know what I'm going to use? I'm going to use one of the items that I picked up along the way here. The frigisite. That's what I'm thinking of. Oh, nice. Good grief, man. What are you trying to do? Jesus. You're an asshole. Fuck you.
Well, that ought to do
predictable.
It. Yes. Essentially predictable, you know, like I knew exactly what was going to be happening next. So that's armor gems, so
can I hope? Can I hope against hope? Is this chapter done? Please? Please?
Yay, yeah. Miracles.
Now is our chance to run past them.
Run past them?
Yeah.
We just beat their ass.
It's behind them.
Behind dummy?
Final heaven!
Awesome! Nice!
Whoa. It finally worked!
Nice! Tifa in her old Final Fantasy VII costume?
Oh,
like,
I can celebrate later. Come on, this way!
That's awesome!
Hurry.
I do like the cowgirl look kind of thing that she had before the main part of the game. This is actually like whenever... what the hell? Oh, these other ones are following?
The two of them have started something. Mediums have been awakening.
Great.
To the next.
And you mean the Azure Prophecy?
Yeah, child.
Is coming true. So what? No matter how many champions arise, the laws of this world are beyond their power.
We are the law.
The only force that can change those laws is the almighty power of a true king.
We must fulfill the Crimson Prophecy. And swiftly.
No, because the Azure Prophecy will win.
Yes.
Blue versus red. Red versus blue. I was trying to remember the theme tune to the RVB show, but... Roses are
Thanks
red,
again. You'll really violets are blue, the back there.
It's me Ooh, against me and obsessed. Me against you.
I'm just glad you're all right. Huge dragons live in the scars. You're lucky you only ran
into the two. Now we fought about six.
Normally people don't set foot near the place, but I heard all the ruckus and knew something must be up.
It's a good
nice.
Thing you did. Gotta say though, you
She fucking does, man.
Oh, well... I might have gotten
lucky. No, girl, you can kick ass.
That's actually one of my master's moves. That was the first time I ever managed to pull
nice.
It off.
Nice. It's because you're...
I live to the north of here, in a town called Nibelheim. Come on
so
by.
So it's weird, like, the timeline for this is actually, like, they said... Tifa in this is actually Tifa from before Final Fantasy VII. Ah! Alright, so I can get Tifa now. Awesome. That's kind of cool. Cool. Yeah. Alright, do you know what? Whenever a chapter kind of raised my expectations, then immediately trounced them and completely ruined them for myself, and then actually had an ending fight, and it was all good. Do you know what? Actually, like, this is a roller coaster ride, guys. It's a roller coaster. Cerberus was shit. Tifa's kind of awesome. But I love the actual articulation of the character. I love the fact they've gone with the older costume as well. Yeah, shit. That was chapter 10 of
World of Final Fantasy. World of Final Fantasy.
The world of the Final the Fantasy.
The world of Final Fantasy.
So thank you very much, guys, for watching. If you actually want to see more episodes of this series, you can hit the subscribe button. That'll be floating around up here somewhere. You can easily grab a hold of it. You hit a wee slap on that, and then you're subscribed to the channel. You can follow and see everything that comes up on the channel on many, many of the playlists that I actually put up. And if you're particularly looking for this playlist and you haven't actually seen any other episodes in the series, and you want to kind of have a context for the things I'm saying and the context of the game itself, there's a playlist buttons that are sitting up here on this side. There actually will be playlists for stuff that I'm currently working on the station, and also the playlist for the previous episodes of this. And if you don't like any of that, well, I don't know if I can really help you too much. I mean, that's what I make. So, guys, if you want to check out the channel, it's youtube.com/pasticheofskin. And, of course, you can always try and catch me while I'm recording these episodes on twitch.tv/pasticheofskin. I want to say thank you very much for watching, and I will see all you dudes in the next episode. Bye-bye.